Outside Health and Fitness Podcast, episode 141, 7 surprising fitness tips for outdoor athletes.
Welcome to the Outside Health and Fitness Podcast. We're getting outside the box, outside our comfort zone, and outside and in shape. If you're bored with the same old fitness routine at the gym and you're ready to try something new, then this is the show for you. We're exploring new and fun ways to get fit on the trail, on the water, on the slopes, and outside.
Hi, this is Steve Stearns from Outside Health and Fitness, and thank you for joining me for another episode. If you're new to the show, we like to stay fit and active by having fun outside. We like to ride, slide, run, walk, hike, bike, golf, rolf, swim, and ski. If it's fun outside and it keeps us healthy, we love it. So if you're like us and you like to have fun outside, then you found the right place. I really love discovering new and interesting ideas for fitness, don't you? There are some amazing and creative tips out there, and sometimes these tips change everything about your routine. Sometimes they're a fun distraction, but either way, I find them really interesting, and I hope you do too. On today's show, you'll discover an easy way to improve your speed after you run, why taking your shoes off could improve your health, and how to exercise longer by keeping your hands cold.
OutsideHealthAndFitness.com.
So it was a lot of fun doing the research for this episode, and I'd like to do more tips episodes in the future. If you would like some tips on a specific topic, please leave me a comment in the show notes for this episode at outsidehealthandfitness.com/141. Okay, enough of that. Let's get right into the fitness tips. So the first tip is perfect if you're like me and you want to increase your running speed. Surprisingly, all the work happens after you run. So this great tip comes from Mindy Sulkin, owner and head coach of the Running Center in New York City. She says to strengthen your quads, hamstrings, glutes, improve your speed and endurance, try wall sitting after your next run. Wall sitting is easy and hard. Now the easy part is find a wall or a smooth tree and lean against it with your feet shoulder width apart. And now the hard part, squat down so your knees are bent at a 90 degree angle and hold that for 30 to 60 seconds. Now, over time, work up so that you can complete 10 sets after every run. If that's not hard enough for you, try lifting one leg and then the other. No, not at the same time. That would be really challenging, but that will make it a little bit harder for you. Now, wall sitting will really help you build some leg strength, and you'll get a chance to wind down after your run and enjoy the outdoors. One of my favorite times to be outside is the morning. It's a quiet and awesome time of day. In fact, fitness tip number 2 is to go early in the fall and winter. You know, at that time of year, at least in the U.S., it gets dark early. So getting outside in the morning to exercise is a good way to get it done. Toward the end of the day, when it's dark out, it's easier to talk yourself out of it. And as a special bonus, working out early is great for anyone who is looking to shed a little fat. So the theory behind this is that doing cardio in the morning before you've eaten can help you burn fat because most of the carbs in your system are depleted. You know, you haven't eaten since dinner. So your body grabs fat to burn for energy. I haven't looked into the research on this, but it seems to make sense. In fact, I've always preferred to work out in the morning and on an empty stomach. Well, not entirely empty. I do like my coffee in the morning, and it turns out that that's a good thing to have before your workout. Like I said, I'm a big coffee fan, so I'm excited to share this tip. Based on a study done at the University of Nebraska, caffeine taken before a workout can help you burn more fat during exercise. Another surprising aspect of drinking some Joe before you go is that caffeine has also been shown to decrease the amount of muscle pain you feel while you're working out. So enjoy a coffee before your next workout to burn more fat, work out longer, and power through your routine. Now this next one probably won't be a tip that you use during colder months, but when it's warm, going barefoot can be great for your health. In episode 138, which you can find at outsidehealthandfitness.com/138, I talked about earthing and how reconnecting with the earth and the negatively charged electrons it radiates can help increase circulation, reduce pain, provide more energy, improve your mood, and even help you sleep. Beyond the incredible benefits you can get from earthing, going barefoot outside can improve your skin health, reduce foot calluses, build arch strength, and enhance sensory stimulation. Now, so your feet don't get lonely being out there and exposed to the elements, another surprising tip for getting the most out of your workouts involves keeping your hands cold. You know what they say, cold hands, warm heart. Well, maybe not. A study conducted by a researcher at Stanford University School of Medicine found that when female participants held hand-cooling devices, they were able to exercise longer. Now, the theory is that keeping your hands cool slows the speed at which your internal temperature rises. Because you're not storing as much heat, you're more comfortable and you can exercise longer. Speaking of comfort, this next tip can help you be more comfortable when you run and may even help reduce or eliminate pain from running. This tip is about increasing your strides per minute. By increasing your footfalls to 180 per minute, you become a more efficient runner. Smaller strides can improve your enjoyment, make running more comfortable, and you may even notice reduced pain if you normally experience pain when running. Now, it may sound like a hard thing to do, but it's actually pretty easy. It's just 3 foot strikes every second. 1 Mississippi. 1 right, missa, left, sippy, right, and so on. Try practicing using your hands and tapping on your knees. Another good way to get the rhythm is to use the free Spotify app for your smartphone and select the running mode. You can select the type of music you like, and the app matches your pace to provide music set at the same beats per minute. Running is a great cross-training activity no matter what sport you enjoy, so I love tips like this that make running more fun and comfortable. When it comes to training for your specific sport, this next tip is perfect. This tip from Coach Schall is for all you outdoor athletes. Coach says, as you get closer to your season, modify your training to be more sport specific. During the off season, you can focus on general fitness to build strength and durability, but you want to really zero in on your specific sport 6 to 8 weeks prior to the start of the season. Giving your body enough time to prepare means a more successful season and a reduced chance of injury. So those are 7 of my favorite tips for outdoor athletes. 1, wall sit after you run. 2, get out early in the fall and winter. 3, drink coffee before you work out. 4, go barefoot when you can. 5, cold hands help you work out longer. 6, increase your strides per minute. 7, start sport-specific training 6 to 8 weeks before the start of the season. If you have some tips you would like to share, I would love to put them in an episode and give you a shout out on the show. As I said earlier, you can leave tips in the comment section for this episode, send me an email, or even leave a free voicemail right from your computer. I'll have links to make it easy for you to submit your tips at outsidehealthandfitness.com/141. I hope you got some value from the show today. In fact, I would love it if you'd leave me a review in iTunes and let me know what you think. Reviews and ratings in iTunes really help other people find the show, and they keep me energized. If you haven't left a review yet, it's super easy. If you're listening on an Apple device using the podcast app, just click on the artwork to see the show notes. Click the link, leave a rating and review in iTunes, and jot down your thoughts. It's that simple. Or visit outsidehealthandfitness.com/141 to leave a review and for links to everything we talked about today, including a link to 50 tips for taking your fitness outside. While you're there, be sure to get your free copy of Fit Fast First Thing, my Tabata morning workout for a quick 10-minute routine you can use to start your day off right. And here's your final tip. It's even better when you do it outside. Well, that wraps up another episode of the Outside Health and Fitness Podcast. I hope you got something of value from the show today that helps you get outside and in shape. For more on taking your health and fitness outside, visit outsidehealthandfitness.com and subscribe to the show. Until next time, I'll see you outside.